Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new episode of the NASCAR Heat 5 Career Mode on the channel. I hope you're all having a great day. Today we go to the Xfinity Series at Iowa, Michigan or something like that. No, not Michigan, but Chicagoland and Pocono. So three Xfinity races coming at you guys here today now as we don't have a Cup Series hot seat for a little bit now as I have been made aware in the comments. So it's Darlington and Bristol will be our two Cup hot seats in the future. Those will be the last two. So hopefully they're both for five-star teams. I'm not sure. Maybe there's one four-star in there, but we're going to find out pretty soon now as we are underway, though, here for the first race of this episode at Iowa. You see a bit of a lighting change there as we go into the replay. Like I said, I would still like to see that be fixed in the future. I'm not sure if it will get fixed in this game, but it was a problem in NASCAR Heat 4 as well. Basically, you can be in a day race that ends at nighttime, and no matter what, though, when you go to the replay at the start of the race, it'll still be nighttime. So it kind of breaks the immersion a little bit, but we're going to deal with it, obviously, throughout this career mode, just like we did in the NASCAR Heat 4 career mode. But Iowa here is where we're at, and that's always been a track that you guys know I struggle at pretty hard. But to my surprise, I was actually being able to move my way forwards a little bit now, as usually back in the NASCAR Heat 4 career mode, I was satisfied with a top 25 run at Iowa. But here we are on the two to go now in stage one, running up in P16. So it wasn't the greatest first stage, but the eight of Daniel Hemric was actually leading the way at this point as we came to the white flag now in stage one, as I dived up the inside of the 39 of Ryan Sieg, passed him, then got to the inside of Justin Allgaier on the final lap of the stage, but couldn't quite pass him. So we would get P15 here in the first and opening stage in Iowa. So wasn't too disappointed with that. Now as I know that usually, just based off the NASCAR Heat 4 career mode and whatnot, this is a track that I run like absolute trash at. So definitely happy with the stage one effort now as we get ready to go green here for the start of stage two. Unfortunately for us, we're going to be starting on the inside lane here behind Joe Graff Jr. now as we are once again underway for stage two. Chase Briscoe, it looks like, stole the stage victory away from Daniel Hemric there at the end of stage one. We're going to get aggressive though right off the bat, go up the inside of Graff Jr. down into turns one, as well as get up the inside of the 21 of Anthony Alfredo now as we come through out of turns two. A little bit of contact there with the RCR driver now as we go down this back straightaway side by side for P12 as we dive down into turns three, but we are going to be able to carry that speed on that bottom to almost get past Alfredo, and then we would eventually complete the pass. Now, as we came through on lap three of the second stage, we had now worked our way inside the top 10, passing drivers like Austin Cindric and whatnot, got up the inside of our teammate of Riley Herbst with two to go on the stage. We passed him for P8, and that's where we would come through through turns three, and now out of turn four on the final lap in stage two, Chase Briscoe with the stage victory again, and we would come through to cross the line in P8 here for stage two. So considering my track record here, extremely happy with an 8th place stage 2 result, but hopefully we can carry this over into the 3rd and final stage and get a very strong effort out of it now, as if we can finish in the top 10 in Iowa, I will be extremely happy. I'll take a top 10 in Iowa over a championship now as we get ready to go green. Of course, I'm kidding about that. Now as the green flag though is out, the 3rd and final stage is underway here in Iowa. A bit of a bump to the back of our teammate of Harrison Burton as we dive down towards turns 1. I said coming into this season that was kind of a race here to a JGR spot in the Cup Series between myself, Burton, and Herbst. Which rookie on this team in the Xfinity program could perform the best? Well, we've proven that we can do that. We got 4 wins on the season. Burton has, what, 1, and Herbst has none so far. But now we came through a little bit later. We had dropped down to P11, being on the outside on that restart, unfortunately, but we would pass Jeremy Clements, get up the inside of Austin Cindric, a little bit of contact there with the Penske driver in the 22 as we dive down into turns 3, trying to clear Cindric for that 9th position as we come through the center of the corner out of turns 4, still side by side there with Cindric down at the front straightaway, but we're going to have the advantage as we go down into turns 1. You can really make that second lane work in turns 3 and turns 4, but it doesn't really work well for turns 1 and 2, and that's what gets me clear of Austin Cindric. Then Jeremy Clements would actually pass him, get to my inside now as we came through out of turns 4 on lap 28 of 34. As we exit the corner, we hit the wall and bounce off the wall into the side of the 51 of Clements. More contact between himself and I as we go down into turns 1. Clements is actually going to go spinning there as we managed to miss him, but he goes up in the air behind us now as someone drove under him, and the caution comes out with 6 laps to go. 100% my fault there as I banged down the wall and obviously I bounced off the wall into the side of Clements, and that was very unfortunate for him, but certainly not what we had wanted to do, but now that would force, obviously, a late race restart here in Iowa. Now as the green flag is back out, thankfully we really didn't get much damage from that moment there. So we are back underway now as we're going to get aggressive again up the inside of Tommy Joe Martin's as we dive down into turns one. We've been able to use late race restarts to execute pretty well here for us in our rookie season of the Xfinity Series. There's we're up the inside of the 98 car, one of the best looking paint schemes, I think, on the Xfinity roster, at least in NASCAR Heat 5. Now has come through out of turns four, but Briscoe would be able to carry the momentum to stay clear, so we would just kind of settle in the sixth position here as we started the final lap, now heading down the back straightaway in Iowa for the final time. It was the 11, though, of Justin Haley leading, but Hemric would send it up the inside as they're going to be side-by-side for the win as we exit turns four, but Haley has the edge coming to the line for the first time this season. Justin Haley picks up the victory as we come through to cross the line in P6. So cannot complain about a sixth place finish at all now in Iowa. Massively, massively exceeded my expectations. I expected it to be down in like P25. So cannot complain at all with that finish. But now that brings us in to Chicagoland Speedway, where we had another subpar qualifying effort like we usually do in every single race pretty much now as we come through to start the race here in Chicago. I don't think we've had more than two top 10 qualifying efforts this season, if that, now as we come through to start the race. So on the inside of the 99 of Josh Bilicki as we dive down towards turns one as he runs at insuranceking.com Toyota Camry as we dive down, or Supra, sorry, this is a Supra now as we come through the center of the corner and out of turns through. There's a lot more Toyotas here in the Xfinity Series than there is in the Cup Series, I've noticed now, as we go down this back stretch into turns three. But it was Ross Chastain who qualified on pole, and he was leading the way out of turns four in front of the second place driver of Justin Allgaier. And you had Justin Haley and Austin Cindric up there in like third and fourth in the mix. Now as we go to the outside of Brandon Brown here with three to go in stage one, our teammate Harrison Burton was in the mix, but that did not work, so I got back to the bottom, and then we started to make up more ground as we were coming through now approaching the final lap in stage one. Some contact there with the 44 of Tommy Joe. Now as we're three wide with Tommy Joe Martins and the 20 of our teammate of Harrison Burton, we passed them both, and on this final lap of stage one we get up the inside here of the zero car through turns three and out of turns four. So we're going to climb up into P12, but coming to the line he actually gets some momentum against me, and we're going to settle in for P13 here in stage one. So definitely not the best stage one effort. Chicagoland, we mentioned Iowa, a track I always struggle at. Chicagoland is probably the mile and a half, other than Texas, I think that I struggle at the most. I think I can actually get a better finish usually out of Texas than I can in Chicago. So I consider this to be at least a top two track on the mile and a half, just out of the tracks that I struggle at the most. So not the most confidence coming into this one either, but we saw what we could do in Iowa. So my confidence at least was a little bit boosted here at the start of this one as we start the second stage in Chicago as we go down towards turns one. Now the inside of Gregson. There you see Chase Briscoe just in front of us now as we get up the inside of him on the exit of turns two. Now on lap two of the stage, a little bit of contact there. He makes the save now as we were three wide with him and the eight of Daniel Hemric as we go down into turn three. And then on the front straightaway, we would finally clear them. We were three wide through the whole corner, and we would climb up now into P9, run down this next group of cars with two to go in the stage. Michael Annette was now leading at this point now as we get up the inside of Austin Cindric as we dive down into turns one behind Alfredo and Allgaier, who were side by side now as we come through out of turns two. So up into the seventh position here with two to go in stage two, maybe showing a little bit more speed than I expected to now as we came through on the final lap heading down into turns three in stage two. We would make a move to pass Justin Allgaier now as we come through out of turns four, but he's going to have the momentum as we come through down the front stretch to the line. Chastain would win stage two. We cross the line P7 just barely behind Justin Allgaier. So we're going to be lining up on the inside line here for this third and final stage, so definitely exactly where I want to be. I'm not sure if we have the speed at this point to win the race now, as it definitely seems like we have more speed, like I said, than I thought we did in this car coming into this one. So definitely know we'll have a chance to do something now as the third and final stage is underway here at Chicagoland Speedway. Allgaier with a very poor restart now, and we're going to get ahead of him with absolutely no problem, as we also gave the 21 of Alfredo a push. We would stay behind him though for the whole lap as we came through out of turn four, now making a pass on the 39 of Sieg. So we move up into the top five, now diving up the inside of Alfredo, three wide with him and the JRM driver of Michael Annette. Now as we dive down into turns one, we're trying to take over the third position at this point here with a little bit over 10 to go as we exit turns two, still side by side with Alfredo and Annette. And then as we came through turns three, Annette falls out behind us, so we're now just side by side with Alfredo, and we use the draft to our advantage from Justin Haley. We move into P3. We would run down Justin Haley now as we came through on lap 18 down the back straightaway into turn three. We dive up his inside, and now we are eyeing a second place position now as we come through out of turn four. Obviously, Haley's going to battle back on the outside as we go down this front straightaway, but I was pretty confident that we might be able to clear him as we go down into turns one. 10 laps to go here in Chicago, nearly making a little bit of contact there with Haley, but we clear him into turns one, and then we would set our sights on Ross Chastain, who started to run the outside lane after we got up into second. So all of a sudden, I'm gaining a ton of time on Chastain, the watermelon boy, as we exit turns two. Now on lap 22, even closer to him. And then on lap 23, six to go, we get right to the back of him as we dive down into turns one. Gonna go around the outside potentially here on Chastain, but it doesn't quite work as it fades through the center of the corner. But we would stick with Ross Chastain now on lap 24, five laps to go at this point, diving up the inside through turns one and out of turns two, but it's not going to work. I tried to side draft Chastain, still doesn't work. Michael Annette had moved up into P3 at this point now, as he was eyeing a potential mistake from myself or Chastain to move him into position to potentially win this race. But again, we dive up the inside out of turns four, side by side with Chastain, but this time we're close enough to side draft him significantly here as we're side by side down the front straightaway. Four laps to go here in Chicagoland, and we are now going to move in to the first position as we dive down into turns one. And at this point, we were trying to run away, but to my surprise, they would be able to stick with me now as we came through out of turns two. So we come through now approaching two laps to go, still in command though, as I knew if I didn't make a mistake, we were going to be okay. We came through starting now the final lap in Chicagoland Speedway out of turn two. We open up the gap maybe by a tenth at the absolute most, but Chastain still within striking distance if I make a mistake as we dive down into turns three for the final time. Annette goes to the top. I stay on the bottom along with Chastain as we exit turns four on the final lap, actually tagging the wall just a tiny bit, but it's not going to matter. We will get win number five on the season. Unbelievable. Now five wins in our rookie season of the Xfinity Series. Cannot complain about how this is going. Obviously, at this point, I already would consider it a disappointment if we weren't a champion now, as obviously we picked up our first Truck Series championship in our rookie season. And if we keep up this performance, we're going to be able to do the same for sure here in the Xfinity Series. Five wins, and we still got quite a few races to go here in the regular season. But obviously, we have to set our sights on the very next race here in the regular season, which would be the Tricky Triangle at Pocono Raceway, a track, once again, I consider these three tracks of this episode tracks I've always struggled at here in the career mode. So definitely didn't have the best outlook coming into this one now, as Iowa went way better than I thought it would. Chicago, of course, went way better than I thought it would. We picked up the victory, but now we start Pocono from P17, and honestly, if we can come out of here with a top 10, I'd be happy with that as well. Now, it's just such a tough track to master, especially in this game. Now, as we come through down the front straightaway, going three wide already, I was actually going to settle in line behind whoever that was, that blue car, but they were just so slow, so I decided to go up the inside. But immediately, the first problem I was noticing with the car in this race is it just felt really tight on through the center of the corner, exit of the corner. The entrance felt pretty good, but on the center and exit of the corner, the car just felt way too tight. So I knew I was in a little bit of trouble. Now as we come through, trouble in front of us though there. Ross Chastain goes sideways. He hangs onto it. Now as we stole the win from him in the last race at Chicago, problems for him early on in the very next race here in Pocono as we dive down into turn three behind Jeffrey Earnhardt. Gave him a little bit of a bump there on that left rear, and then I would go wide. There you see the tightness kicking in, and that allows Chastain to actually get back past me. So we came through right to the final lap of the stage. Through the final corner, we were still behind these guys. Contact with Chastain as we're going to be three wide in the middle. Coming to the line, it's going to be P14 in stage one. You might be wondering, why in the world did I just slam into the side of the zero of Jeffrey Earnhardt? I actually let go of my steering wheel coming to the line, and then the force feedback caused it to kick out of control, and that's why I drove into the side of the zero car. But we would set our sights now on stage two. So unfortunately, We did not pick up any points there in stage one, which is not great for us, but obviously it doesn't really make a difference for us right now if we get 0 points or not at this point. We're just here for playoff points. So if I can't get a playoff point, I don't care how many points we get now as we start the second stage, getting very aggressive early on. I saw a very poor restart from my teammate of Herbst, so I hopped on the opportunity to get down in front of him. So we're up into P11 or P12 as we come through. Turns one into the back there of Jesse Little as we come through out of the corner. So a little bit of damage on the front end of the car, but it really isn't performance impacting. So we came through, now heading down towards turns three on the inside of Jeffrey Earnhardt as we dive into the corner, trying to take over the 11th position behind us. We got Chastain and now Herbst, who dives up my inside. We make contact with our teammate. Now we're going all the way up the track with Earnhardt. He's gonna hit the wall now, as I was doing what I could to make sure we didn't put him in the wall, but I just could not get out of the throttle enough, I guess, now as I decided I wanted to still stay in it. Unfortunately, that did not work out for him. Now, as we're going to dive up the inside of the 9 of Gregson as we try to take over the spot, and then it just goes all to crap again as we go down into turns 1. Now we're in to the left rear of our teammate of Herbst. Gregson's on my outside. This car is going by everywhere. We're down now to P16 on the final lap of the second stage, and we would actually pass Daniel Hemric back though as they came through out of turns 3 on the final lap of stage 2 is up the inside of Gregson, but it wasn't going to be enough. We come through to cross the line a position worse than we did in stage 1, so P15 here in stage 1, Chase Briscoe with the stage 2 victory. So far, not the race we're looking for here in Pocono. Now, as I expected, if we did so good at Iowa and Chicago, that we would be able to back it up here in Pocono. But so far, not going quite as we had hoped. Now, as the green flag is out, the third and final stage is underway. A very slow restart from Clements already. Now, with 7 laps to go here in Pocono. Now, behind us, we got Daniel Hemric. We got Gregson up there in the mix with us. But Chase Briscoe leads the way down into turns 1 now. As he's had a lot of speed this season in the career mode, but he hasn't had the wins to show for that speed. Now, as he's gotten some stage wins, some playoff points, of course. And now, as we come through out of turns 1 side by side with that car, here's actually getting to the side of him. Now, he's going to get up the inside of the 9 of Noah Gregson. We pass Gregson as we go down towards the tunnel turn here behind Jeremy Clements. Now, as we would then make it 3 wide on the exit of the tunnel turn as we went down into turns 3. So, we're going to be able to pass Clements, I hope, but he might fight back on that second lane. Now, as we maybe made a little bit of contact there with Clements. Now as we go 3 wide up the middle between the 4. Now as we go down the front straightaway using that draft from the 18 of Herbst. Now as we're also going to get up the inside of Justin Allgaier. So now up into P11. Now as we are somehow in striking distance of a top 10. Sure enough, we get past Anthony Alfredo, take over P10, and then we're going to pass the 39 of Ryan Sieg and take over P9. So that draft works wonders down the straightaways, because then we would run down Justin Haley, take over P8 with just 4 laps to go here in Pocono. Chase Briscoe still out front at this point, but then on lap 15, Haley actually was able to dive up my inside into turns 1, and that completely hurt everything I had now, as he would be able to pass me, and then the 47 would also get past me as well. So we would then drop down into the 10th position here as we go down this first back straightaway. Chase Briscoe leading the way, still just praying, I'm sure, that it was going to stay green, and as we came through, sure enough, on the final lap, I had just nothing after we got past. So it was still P10 as we went down into turns 3 for the final time here at the Tricky Triangle in Pocono Raceway. Chase Briscoe would win here in Pocono as we exit turn 3, nearly getting into the wall, but we do keep it out now as Haley falls down a spot, and we're going to come through to cross the line with a 10th place finish here in Pocono. So cannot complain. We got top 10s at least in every race today, as well as obviously we picked up win number 5 on the season. That's a big thing, win number 5. Definitely happy with that now, as it's always important to get as many playoff points as possible, and right now we've got 28 of those, so we're in a very good position already going into the playoffs if we don't pick up another playoff point at all in the regular season. But as always, if you guys enjoyed this episode, you know what to do. In the next one, I think it's still going to be just all Xfinity races. I think we're doing really just all Xfinity races probably for the next 2 or 3 episodes at least, just to round out the regular season, unless there's maybe another cup hot seat somewhere. I don't think there is, but in the next one, I'm not sure what track we're going to yet, but we're about to find out. Maybe like I actually really have no idea. Maybe a Road America's got to be coming up soon, but we'll see right here. Oh, it's Indianapolis for the Brickyard. So that's going to be an interesting one. Another track that I don't have a great track record at in a series like Xfinity. So we'll see what we can do. But thank you all for taking the time out of your day to watch this episode. I will see you guys in the next one. And have yourselves a great day, everybody.